five, six, seven, eight. Dance with me in my backyard, boy. Looking super fine in your corduroy. Drive me round the block, we can go in a loop. And we'll turn the volume up on some good boy band tunes. I feel the fresh air, I can feel it. Many of you have asked me what it's like to go to mortuary school. Today I'm at the Pittsburgh Institute of Mortuary Science, helping assist with the restorative arts class. Here we are showing how to rebuild a face as well as cosmetize, and has always been one of my favorite classes.
Wipe, wipe, wipe it down, wipe, wipe.
So some of you guys asked me for an embalming room tour, which is totally fine. Welcome inside. You'll notice that you are not in a spooky basement. We got our chemicals over here, and you might recognize some of them if you work at a funeral home. Personal protective equipment always. Face masks, shields, jumpsuits. We try to keep ourselves and others safe in here. Our super clean workspace area with lots of room to walk around. Everything's put away. And we have our pretty simple embalming machine, if you've never seen one before. More organized supplies, of course. And if you have any more questions, drop a comment. Stay safe.
restoring a post-mortem face. I'm using mortuary wax to create a replica of the right ear. After molding the wax into shape, I fill in the empty spaces so that I have something to adhere it to. After more sculpting and adding definition, we are ready for makeup. Follow for part two. If a death occurs, the hospital will call the funeral home in charge, and the funeral director will take the first call information and head out to the hospital, making sure the removal cot is level to the bed so we can safely pull them over. A sheet is placed over the body to ensure privacy. We then unbuckle and ready the cot for the decedent, carefully pulling them over where the head is rested on a pillow. These two women did a great job as a team and buckled the decedent back into safety, where they wheeled him back to a mock example of a van and into the funeral home's care. Usually we show up with a team for a home removal, however in a hospice setting there's usually RNs that'll help with the removal. It's not often the family member stays in the room, but they are welcome to. If someone dies somewhere too close to the ground for the cot, we use what is called a Reeves sleeve. It has four handles at the corner, making it easier to lift the decedent.